University of Hawaii scientists have discovered that severe birth defects related to the Zika virus occurred in Hawaii in 2009, much earlier than 2016 when the connection was first made between Zika and an increased likelihood of microcephaly during outbreaks in Brazil and Puerto Rico. Microcephaly is a congenital condition associated with incomplete brain development and characterized by an abnormal smallness of the head. The scientists from the Department of Tropical Medicine, Medical Microbiology, and Pharmacology at the John A. Burns School of Medicine uncovered the information by testing samples collected voluntarily from Hawaii mothers. They had delivered babies between 2007 and 2013 at Kapi'olani Medical Center for Women and Children in Honolulu, a Hawaii Pacific Health hospital affiliated with the medical school. The samples are stored at the biorepository.
Well, we found six mothers who were microcephaly, who had babies with microcephaly, but not all were Zika positive. 50% of them were Zika positive. So that only means that Zika is in Hawaii at least since 2009.
Researchers say they were not surprised by the discovery because there had been a Zika outbreak in Micronesia in 2007.
Zika has been around in the Pacific for a long time. It only came to be recognized or got a recognition when we started having babies with microcephaly in Brazil in late 2015, early 2016. So I think we are trying to go into that direction to we can have a rapid test as well as reliable test for diagnosis of Zika.
The next step is to broaden the search for birth defects other than microcephaly associated with Zika virus.
The bank which we have currently can give us some guidance of what might be happening in the future. Always, sometimes it's better to go back in the history and look what's happening in there to predict what might happen in the future too.
The key to preventing Zika-related birth defects is proactive tracking of women and their partners who want to have babies. The scientists say none of their work would have been possible without the thousands of donated samples.
We really want to thank the women and specifically the mothers of Hawaii who have generously donated their placentas and blood samples for research purposes.